Friends, I have two important issues to comment upon. Number one, the same old story of the CBI conducting itself in a manner befitting its name of Congress Bureau of Investigation. We have the latest now. The CBI want to withdraw the disproportionate assets case against the BSP chief. Earlier in this month, the CBI has decided to drop the case against the SP chief, and simultaneously CBI is leaking out information. As per the media reports, that it want to tell the court and the country that Ishrat Jahan is innocent. Mulayamji, innocent. Mayawati ji, innocent. Ishrat Jahan, innocent. What is happening to this government and what is happening to this country? Desh ko kya ho raha hai? Who registered the case against Mulayam Singh ji? Who registered the case against Sushri Mayawati ji? Why this change of heart? At whose behest the CBI is functioning? It is very shocking to note that the Congress party, after the CBI has filed charge sheet in Ishrat Jahan's encounter case, is trying to politicalize the entire issue and gain mileage, and it's even ready to compromise on the nation's security. As per the leaks to the media, it is also said that the person who was accompanying Ishrat Jahan, Pranesh Pille, alias Javed Sheikh, is a IB implant. What is really baffling? In order to settle scores with BJP, the CBI is being used by the government even to defame the most important investigating agency, IB. In this connection, people should not forget that the Congress is notoriously known for using, misusing, abusing CBI. One, to harass political opponents. Two, to keep the supporting parties under control. Three, to win over the neutrals as and when necessary. This government is surviving courtesy CBI, otherwise it would have gone long back. Now it is coming to the end of its tenure, that's why it's redeeming itself. Due to Samajwadi Party and Bahujan Samaj Party. Just, it is on the fag end of its tenure. Jo abhi tak unko jo samardhan mila in partiyon se, bhayankar vifalata hone ke baad bhi, sarkar har ek morcha mein pura vifal hone ke baad bhi, ye log Congress ko saath dete raha. Massive scams and scandals, total failure, policy paralysis, highest inflation, price rise, failure on each and every front, rupee becoming weak, fiscal deficit, revenue deficit, trade deficit, current account deficit, trust deficit, In spite of all this, these parties were supporting. So now the Congress thought they must repay. And why they have not done it in the beginning? Because they wanted the support to continue. Otherwise, coming under public pressure, these parties may change their stand. Now it is a fag end. That alone can be a reason. Otherwise, koi karan nahi tha. We have seen how the CBI conducts itself with regard to DA case against Mulayam Singh ji, against Mayawati ji. How CBI acted with regard to Sajjan Kumar and Jagadish Shetter. How the CBI conducted itself. Coal scam. The CBI case is being, the Coalgate case is being monitored by the Supreme Court. In spite of that, the CBI director goes to the minister, takes instruction from him, and the CBI sits with the joint secretaries of the core ministry against whom the CBI is making inquiries. And then you have the famous Railgate case. Even before making inquiries, they start giving clean chit to the rail minister. He is not involved, but his name is being misused. It's a watertight case about the rail minister. And in the Coalgate case, the government was caught pants down. And the CBI director himself told the court that he was summoned by law minister. Joint secretaries of the core ministry were present. They asked them to remove this para and include this. Suggested changes. It all shows how amenable the CBI is to the political pressure. If this can happen to a case monitored by the highest court of the land, anyone can imagine how impartial the investigating agency will be conducting itself in a high-profile case like the Gujarat encounters. The government and the CBI need to explain to the people why this volte-face on these DA cases, why they filed case, why they took this much time. And why now they have decided to withdraw the cases? They owe an explanation. Pura desh ko, Congress party ko, aur CBI ko samadhan dena padega. Ye keval unka ghar ka mamla nahi hai. Wo antarangik, unka antarangik mamla nahi hai. Having failed on each and every front, the Congress party now thinks the best way to fight the BJP and the Gujarat chief minister is activize CBI, use it, misuse it, politicalize and implicate Gujarat chief minister and his colleagues. And while doing so, they are ready to compromise on the national security. They are ready to defame the other arms of the government investigating agencies. But we would urge upon the people to please understand and remember the credibility of the CBI. Vis-a-vis in the backdrop of the cases I have cited, there are an umpteen number of cases. The case with regard to the other DMK leaders, how slow it is going. And how crude this government can act, DMK gets out of the ministry, next day, there is a raid in Chennai by ED. And there was a function in Mumbai where Sri Narendra Bhai Modi was the chief guest, Diamond Merchants Association building inauguration or so. Narendra Bhai tells those people, you are felicitating me, you are being noted, and you will be raided. Exactly the fourth day, the income tax raids them. The income tax, the IB, the ED, the CBI, the Raj Bhavans, the governors, everybody is being used. And then they try to divert the attention of the people from the main issues faced by the country by highlighting this case as if Shah Irshad Jahan is a Mahan. And now they are saying she just accompanied. How can an innocent lady or a girl accompany these people, go to Ahmedabad from Mumbai, go to, even there were stories about other places also, visiting Lucknow, visiting other places. What is the explanation? Then how can there be accompanied by two Pakistani nationals? How about that? They have no confirmation. No, we have information how the CBI is functioning. They may not have confirmation. This, she traveled to Ahmedabad and other places with three others. Two of them were Pakistani nationals. They have never explained.